Today on Samcraft, I'm going to be doing a comparison between the Bambu Lab H2D 3D printer and the Bambu Lab X1C 3D printer. I'm going to be doing a poop test, finding out which machine poops more with multicolor prints. I'll be doing an overall maximum volume print test, maxing these guys out to the largest XYZ object they will print, showing you those differences in real life, and also be doing some sound tests to figure out which machine is quieter should you want to run this in your home. To kickstart this party, let's go ahead and poop first. It's always great to get a good poop in, so let's start with that. For this, I'm going to be designing a multicolor Samcraft keychain because why not? Let's get some functionality with our poop test. Maybe it's something that'll make its way into some customer orders, a little bit of swag, or if nothing else, it's something that's a little more useful to show this functionality between the two models. As you guys saw earlier, I had four keychains that pretty much came loose on the build plate. This last one here at the very front left is also warped on the edge, so it's also a throwaway. But I've been watching this for a little bit because this is the very end of the print job, and it's been air printing the white filament for a little bit. So far, the X1 carbon has not picked up on that, which is okay in this case because I just want it to finish the job. But I'm here watching it just to see how it does finish out. This is probably painful for some of you to watch, right? We are knowingly let it run whenever it shouldn't be running. But it is almost there and we just want to finish the test. All right. Tests are done. We'll go ahead and take the X1 carbon plate off and combine these four failures that I pulled off onto the plate, along with the air print spaghetti onto the plate. So we got that guy done. Let's also get his poop bucket. Not a ton, right? But we only had, what, 7 color changes? So there's that. Now let's go over here to the H2D. Go ahead and pull this guy's build plate out of here. No failures with this one, although that honestly is not a printer issue, as it probably is Sam's issue on cleaning the plate. Grab this poop bucket from way back here. Bring it out. And let me take this stuff over to the table so we can actually look at this and compare the two. First up is the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon. Here we have the printed plate with all the keychains, including the mess ups and the little air print. Everything we printed is here on the plate. We have our tiny little purge tower at the top right. And then probably most importantly, we have our little pile of poop here. You can see one little clump is gold and white. That was the initial machine startup and purging of old filament. And then otherwise we have a little pile of white to gray, white to black, and the transitions with that. Overall, not that much, but this print job was only, I think, 9 layers. So it only had that many layers to change color on, of which not all the layers actually had a color change. And then moving over here to the H2D's print plate, we have all the tags. We have the little purge tower or prime tower up there. And then its smaller little pile of poop. Much, much smaller, more concise, more dense, but that's also because you never had it going from white filament to black filament. It was only ever white or black. and most of these were the initial or final purging when the print job started or finished. Well, love it or hate it, think it's a great example, or Sam just didn't do enough layers to really see the poop outcome. This is the keychain, and it's upside down. So that is the keychain. This is the side that was against the print plate, so it's got the nice shinier quality, the better outcome. And then this side is what was facing up. It's not as good of a result, but that's normal with your top layer lines or the very top portion of your print. But overall though, it's still pretty good. So between the two models, we can see very, very minimal differences because, again, this was a very low layer count model, but we're able to see at least the size of the poops being a lot more, well, dense and compact with the H2D versus all X1Cs having a little bit of runny time and a little bit of stringing. Now, I don't think that anyone out there is probably surprised at this result. It's definitely one of the main selling features and really cool factors about the H2D is that it has two nozzles. You can load it up, and once you get the job going, there's very, very minimal waste, if any at all. Compared to the X1 Carbon, P1S, P1P, A1, A1 Mini, aka every other Bambu lab that's been existing, those, you've got your purging between color changes, and you just got to get the tubes cleaned before you start rocking and rolling with your other color. Again, this is probably not the best execution of it since my model was rather short, but hopefully you're still able to get the gist of it and see the differences between the two. All right, with that done, the next test I want to run is a visual representation of the maximum print volume for both machines. It's easy enough to quote you numbers or let you see numbers on a build plate, but actually seeing these volumes in real life is going to be more useful, and if nothing else, something pretty cool for you to see. Actual physical representations of the max build volume. So what I did in Bambu Studio was to connect to the printers, go ahead and drop in a primitive cube into Bambu Studio, and then finagle with the dimensions until I got to the point that Studio wasn't fussing at me that it was too large. What you see written on these build plates or advertised as build or print size is not necessarily what the software is going to allow you to do. Now, you could go in and edit the machine settings and parameters to get more volume out of your build plate, but I didn't do that for this test. I'm just using the default stock profiles so that you guys can see what you can expect without having to modify stuff. Once I had that maximum size from Bambu Studio, I then went over to Tinkercad, designed myself a box so that we're not printing giant cubes, sliced it up, sent it over to the printers, and now each of these are running their biggest box they can print. The H2D, I think, is about a 16-hour print. The X1 Carbon is around a 10-hour print. So we're gonna let these guys run. We're gonna trust the process. Hopefully the time lapses on the machines record and capture everything correctly. And I'll see you guys tomorrow when these print jobs are done. It is the next day, but here is our boxes of comparison. On this hand, the X1 Carbon's maximum print size, and on this one, the H2D. There's a little bit of layer line inconsistencies because I had some filament changes. The H2D had one of the spools get tangled, so it had to sit for a little bit, but the actual volume differences do at least show, and they are quite a bit different. What exactly do I have planned for these boxes now that I've spent overnight to print them? I have no clue, but I wanted to give them to you guys so you had a visual representation, an actual physical object that you could compare to Sam and see, okay, that's how big the H2D prints. Or, okay, that's not a whole lot bigger when you compare the H2D with the X1 Carbon. A lot of the print size is going to be dependent upon what you intend to print, whether it be helmets or cosplays. I mean, you can definitely fit a head in this, no problem. But if you have a larger head than me, or you just want to go big time, definitely the H2D is a bigger box for your head to go in. While the height differences between the machines is one consideration, me personally, I am more about the larger build plate as far as X and Y, because I can fit more products or more objects on a print plate in a single job. The H2D definitely beats out the X1 Carbon in that, but it's not as big as I think some people were dreaming or hoping or expecting, so I don't know. take it for what it's worth. You've got to look at these numbers, the actual real life results, compare it with what you currently need or you think you will need, and make a decision from there. Either way, I did want to print these for you guys so you could at least see, compared with Sam's head, that's the size differences between the two. The last test I want to run is a sound test. I've got a sound meter here. It is not super, super high quality, but it is at least a meter. And I want to determine between the X1 Carbon and the H2D, which one is quieter. Should you decide to run these in your home, which perhaps that's where most people do use these, the level of sound coming from the printer is something that's pretty important, especially if you run these near your bedroom or you just have a quiet home in general. To try and make this test as accurate as possible, I'm going to be leaving the sound meter at one specific location, about 7 inches away from the printer for all of the various tests. As I get screenshots, I'll try and also video the machine and then also the sound meter together. But if I don't have that, I'll put text on the screen to let you know what exactly is going on at the point that I'm filming the sound meter. That way, hopefully this will make a little more sense. I'm going to be doing the same position at the sound meter on the X1 Carbon. And then whenever this printer is done running, I'll move it to the H2D, run the exact same file, and try and get as close to apples, a 10 apples comparison that I can get. Again, this is not scientific, but it's the best I can do. The X1 Carbon is laying down its first layer, which is pretty quiet. I do want to point out and at least mention that I do have this modification that I've printed on the X1 Carbon that raises the top glass and gives us a vent. This is what's needed for me to be able to print PLA consistently in my workshop with this front door closed, but it's also going to make this a little bit more noisy than if the lid was closed. So this is not directly out of the box factory setup test, but this is a real life test of how I run the machine and the modification I have to get good results. At around 60 decibels is what the printer's doing as it's moving more of its fast normal speed. So I would say 60 decibels is pretty standard for this machine when it runs, at least again with this meter at this distance. So from this distance, maybe about 6 feet or so, it looks like we got maybe 53 decibel reading. So that's not too bad, right? From my distance, I can definitely hear the fan noise. I don't know that that picks up as well on my sound meter, but fan noise being a little high pitched, it tends to stick out more. That's about the loudest thing I hear though, the machine movement, not distracting or anything like that. If anything, just that fan noise is what I notice the most. So looking right now, we have the fan noise running on the extruder, but the actual reading from the sound meter was somewhere around 51 decibels. Not bad at all. The fan noise is a lot less pronounced from the outside here, just as I'm standing here listening. It is not as tinny or metallic sounding. However, this Bambu Lab H2D does have the built-in vent. That's what you see right here at the front. This opens for air intake or outlet, and it's a lot more closed up. Remember that X1 Carbon, I have this 3D printed riser, which definitely makes it louder. So not really great comparison if we're thinking out of the box, but just here with the Bambu Lab H2D, it is a lot quieter of a machine. All right, here we go. This is our filament purge line at the front. So we're about to rock and roll. First layer is off and running. So let me be quiet and let you guys see the sound meter. So the only times I'm seeing any kind of spike in the sound meter with this first layer is whenever it does its travel moves. So this portion right here, where it's laying down that first layer line, it's not picking up anything with the door closed. It is the initial fast travel movement that you get these small little spikes of, but it's not loud or obnoxious by any means. All right, there we go. We've got our extruder fans kicking on. Go ahead and close the door. Let's see what sound reading we have with the fans on now. Not too bad, 52 decibels from the machine. And then here's a little worst case scenario. It's printing, the fans are running, the door is open, and here's the sound reading we're getting. So while the H2D is running through its print job and I'm literally camped out waiting for an AMS color change that may not happen, I figure I'll talk a little bit about some other points that you may be wanting or expecting me to cover in this video as far as comparing the two and why I'm not talking about them. First one is going to be price. Prices fluctuate, prices change, but more importantly, price is something that you yourself can easily go see and interpret very quickly. If I was to tell you a price, it may become quickly outdated, or honestly, it would take me longer to tell you the price than it would take you just to see it. Another consideration is going to be overall print size. You know, how large is this printer? How large is that printer? This is information that's published on Bambu Lab's website and is also going to be readily available on the internet. I'm really trying to keep this video to the really core meat and taters of the differences of the two, and then also specifically pulling from my viewers questions that they had from my first video on the H2D. Those were print size, print quality, poop, and then also noise. All right, so I was able to catch that one for you guys. 53 decibels, somewhere around there for the reading from the meter down here at the table again, not stuck up there at the spool at least. So there's that result. It sounded quieter to me, but I don't remember if it actually was. And then one last look here with the door open, fans going, we're reading at about 61.5 decibels. This is full fan speed as far as part cooling and extruder, but then with the door closed, we get a much lower reading. All right, all right. So our print jobs are done. We have the gold and the black from the X1 carbon. And this little thing that I printed is an SD card holder. I have a tendency to lose these with my cameras, so I thought it was a pretty cool little file. Definitely slides together, easy to print, and a practical object as well. There really is something just so satisfying about a functional print. And honestly, while what I make and sell for my business are very functional prints, it's fun to do something like this for myself. And honestly, I probably don't do it as often as I should, because this is the real cool factor of having a 3D printer, is to be able to, as an average everyday person, have something, look for it, a model online, whether it be free or paid, get it, download it, and bring it into fruition just with your 3D printer. So while it was not completely scientific, at least I was able to capture Sam's workshop sound levels between the two models and have the data for you to review. I feel like the H2D is quieter overall, but honestly, the figures may show that it's not that great of a change. But here in person, with my own ears in my shop, I definitely feel like the H2D is the quieter machine between the two. A month or two ago, I had the X1 carbon inside the house in our living room because I would use it for prototyping objects at night while everyone else was asleep. But that guy, I had to run it on the silent print mode because it was pretty loud. I have no plans on taking the H2D into my house, but if I did, I wouldn't have any concerns over noise with that one. So for me, in a real world stance, the H2D definitely is quieter. Well guys, that is going to be it for my real life things that really matter test between the H2D and the X1C. We have done our volume size, our maximum print size. We did our poop test. Who pooped more? Was there much of a difference? And then we did our sound test. To me, those are the three biggest things that are really going to make a difference, but that may also be hard to tell from just looking at website data and tech specs. Now that you have seen the differences, I am curious to hear from you. Do you think that the H2D was a home run, that it is a great brand new flagship model from Bambu Lab? Or are you maybe an X1C carbon user or maybe prospective customer thinking, you know what, I don't see the big deal. I think I'll stick with that size. Either way, leave me a comment down below. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. If you got ideas for more content, I'm all ears, but I appreciate you watching as always. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.